Welcome to the Knitted Cupcake Podcast, episode 13. Incorporating some more ASL, 13. We had 12 last week, 13 this week. Hey! It has been a few weeks, and that is mainly due to the fact that I just got back from spring break. So I took a week off, and yeah, it just didn't happen, and that's totally okay. I want to say welcome to all of you new viewers. I've had, you know, a handful of new subscribers, so thanks for hitting that subscribe button and checking out my podcast, and welcome back to all of you returning viewers. I really appreciate that you want to take time out of your day to spend with me. It really means a lot to me, so welcome to all you new viewers, and thanks for coming back to all of you returning viewers. Let me introduce myself. My name is Lacey, and I am the host of this podcast. I live in Wenatchee, Washington, central Washington, and spring has sprung. I have buds, little baby leaves on the tree outside my window. The weather is marginally warmer. And I could not be more excited that we are out of winter. places that you can find me. You can find me, obviously, here on YouTube. Hey. Ravelry, you can find me as W-O-U Knitter. And we also have a podcast group, which is the Knitted Cupcake Podcast. Search that in the groups tab and you'll find us. In there we have a chatter thread of just kind of ask me anything questions, introduce yourself. I will have a giveaway thread in there after this episode goes up, so stay tuned for that. I'll go into that in a little more detail later on in the episode. I'm also on Snapchat. You can find me as Knitted Cupcake, and I'm still not totally sure how the whole Snapchat thing works, so things don't go to my story very often. I'm only kind of snapping a few individual people, but I'm trying to get better at it, because I've noticed I've had a few people add me. So if you've added me on Snapchat, why don't you let me know via, like, Instagram private message or Ravelry private message, so I can, and I'll add you back. There's just a lot of people in the past that have added me, like, prior to podcasting, that I'm like, I don't know you. You don't need to follow me on Snapchat. I don't need to follow you. So go ahead and message me on one of the other social media outlets and let me know kind of your username for Snapchat, and that you added me, and then I'll add you back, just because I know that you're a podcast watcher. So yeah, let's kind of get into this a little bit. I'm gonna start off today with what's running in my diffuser. I've got my diffuser running back over here in the corner, and today I was wanting just a really light, fresh, kind of spring, not floral, because I don't really have a lot of floral oils, but just something light and fresh for spring, because spring is here. And so today, I don't know if that'll show, but I have, I found this recipe on Pinterest, I think, and they just called it the spring blend, but it has ylang ylang, lemon, and peppermint in it. I'm not running it, this blend, for any necessary health purposes or mental clarity boosts or anything like that. It just smells good. And so it has, I'll give you the recipe real fast. It has 3 drops of ylang ylang. It has 6 drops of lemon. And then 2 drops of peppermint. So that is what's running in my diffuser today. I don't think you'll be able to hear the little water burbling around, but if you do, that's what it is. And now what am I wearing? This is a shawl that I finished a couple weeks ago on the podcast. And this is my Hemrick shawl by Lindy or Lindy Christina. I still haven't figured out how to put that D-I. I don't know if it's a die or a D. And I called it my Luna shawl, But it is the Hemrick shawl, and it is it was a test knit that I did for her, and it is now live on Ravelry, so go check it out. She's got a lot of really amazing patterns. This is the only one that I've knit up, but it was a fun knit. It is drop stitches and garter, so pretty potato chippy, good TV watching. It is a big ol' asymmetrical triangle shawl. I did this out of 3 skeins of Juniper Moon Finley Dappled DK, and it is a color that isn't available for purchase, so they called it F. I don't really know why. I think it's because it was either a test color or it was a color that didn't turn out right. But yeah, it's a gorgeous periwinkle lavender colorway, and it is 50% merino, 50% silk, so it's really drapey, nice and lightweight for the spring, yet is warm, because like I said, the weather is only warmed up marginally in the last couple weeks. So that's what I'm wearing. And yeah, I've got iced coffee, cold brew, homemade cold brew kicking in my cup today. And I am going to thank Stephanie from Mean Girl Podcast for kind of filling me in on, hey, you can make cold brew in your French press. Da-da-da. So, and I'll get more into about Stephanie in my chatter at the end of the episode. But little teaser, I got a meter. So cool. So I'll talk more about that at the end of the episode when we get into more chit-chat. But so thank you, Stephanie, for reminding me or telling me of that little trick, because it's delicious, and now I have homemade cold brew to enjoy all the time, and it's a little cheaper than buying it from Starbucks, so thank you for that. Let's move on. Let's jump into, not whips, finished objects. I have 3 finished objects to share with you guys, which, you know, seems fair enough. I have got hair all over a project bag. That's really disgusting. I'm sorry. 3 finished objects to share with you guys. And that's about 1 finished object a week since I podcasted last. The first thing that I want to share with you, and I believe this makes pair, I'm really bad. I think it's pair number 7 for the year of my box of socks, but these are my, and I ended up calling these my Meredith's March socks on my Ravelry page. And so I am trying to get better about posting notes about the things that I make and at least having a project page for them on my Ravelry. So these are up on my project page. And these I did toe up 2 at a time. I cast on, I think, 12 stitches with the Judy's Magic cast on, increased every other row up to 64 stitches. I knit these on a US 0 2mm needle. And I did a true afterthought heel. I was super scared, super nervous. I've done the Susan B. Anderson smooth operator sock afterthought heel, where you put in the waist yarn and then pick it out and that kind of a thing. I found that to be horribly fiddly, and I didn't like it. I did it on my sexy lumberjack socks that I made back in December, and then I at that point decided, nope, afterthought heel, not for me. However, I kept hearing more and more about the Kirby Werby tutorial on YouTube, which is a true afterthought. You put in a stitch marker where you want your heel to go, you pick up stitches above and below it, and then you cut your yarn. Whew! I was terrified that I was gonna ruin these pair of socks because I had to cut my yarn to put in my heel. But these turned out amazing. I could not be happier with the outcome. I have not woven in any ends yet. So, I mean, there's no gap there. There's no hole. They fit my heel fantastic. I've always, on my lumberjack socks, this little point where you're done decreasing and you start to kitchen her together, kind of like bat wings out a little bit on my heel, and I don't like that look. I want it to really fit and hug my heel nicely, and these definitely do. So if you are curious about trying an afterthought heel, if you've tried the Susan B. Anderson and like me, we're not a big fan of it, I would really, really recommend checking out the Kirby Worry tutorial here on YouTube, because I'm sold. I am going to do so many afterthought heels now because I can just go around and around and around and knit, 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 and then slap in a heel afterwards. And yeah, so I may be a convert. I do still love my fish lips because heel, there's still definitely a place for heel flap and gusset, but I'm really digging this heel right now. And I will continue to do more of those. So this yarn is the Schoppelwoll Das Paar, really crummy German, in the color Warm Front, which is 2208. And it is a perfectly matched pair. And the really cool thing with these, from toe all the way up to cuff, none of the striping patterns repeat itself. And I think I could have made it a little bit longer and got even more on there, because the heel, I wanted to match the toe because that block of orange was really cool. And so this little bit of green is actually like before the toe. So it would go a little stripe of green, orange, little stripe of green. So I have little stripe of green, orange, that was gonna go into another little stripe of green. So they're like, the heel is the only thing that repeats from the toe, which is really fun. So the Das Paar is really, really cool yarn that I've knit with before and will probably knit with again. My second finished object, I'm shuffling things around here, is my, I'm gonna have to scoot back a little bit for this. This is my exploration station, and I have 1.5 million ends to weave in, because Stephen West likes a lot of ends, I've decided. So I have to weave them in, but it is off the needles. The hard part is done. I'm really excited. It is smaller than I thought it would be at this point, but it's not blocked yet. So I know this sucker is going to grow. So the ends are, yeah, it's just not, I don't know, it's not as big as I thought it was gonna be right now. But like I said, I still, look at all of these ends, it's crazy. But yeah, so it'll block out, it will grow, and I'm gonna wear it all the time once the weather cools down again, I'm sure. So this I finished in time for the Westknit 17 cowl that Janine from the Yarning You podcast is hosting, and I'm really excited about it. I called it a finished object because it's off the needles. I may have a different definition of finished object than other people, considering there's no ends woven in, or and it's not blocked, but I don't care. All the hard work is done, so it's done. I knit this out of Madeline Tosh, both sock and twist light, and the colors are, the green is grasshopper, the pink is prairie fire, the blue is Nassau blue, and this gray, which I'm gonna take off so you can see this edge. It's got a really awesome I-cord edge on it. This gray color, that's just gonna wash out and just look gray. You can't really see the colors. But this is Nighthawk, and it is gray with these little blips, and I don't think you're ever gonna be able to see that, of a rainbow. And they really pop up on that I-cord edge, because it just is this little rainbow that randomly pops up along there. So I love it. I could not be more happy with how this turned out. I probably won't make another one, but it was a really enjoyable knit. So If you, I would recommend it to anybody who is looking to knit a Stephen West pattern, because it has a lot of really awesome techniques, from the short rows in those little wedge sections, brioche, there's a slip stitch section, there's the chevron edge. It was really a ton of fun to knit, and I'm looking forward to being able to wear it now. So I'm gonna put this shawl back on. It's a little cold in my dining room today. Okay, my final finish object. I knit yesterday. I started yesterday and then finished up the last little bits for today. And this, I'll talk about it and then I'll talk about the reason why I made it. And I'll try to kind of hold it together. But this little cutie patootie right here is Bon Bon the Bunny. And this is a Susan Claudino pattern that I pretty much did everything exactly as she said, except for the tail. She wanted you to knit a tail. It's a bunny. I felt like it needed a little fluffy pom-pom butt. So Bon Bon has a little fluffy pom for the butt. So Susan's pattern, let's see if I can get a little close-up of her face there. Look at how cute she is. Okay, so this guy, girl, she's a girl. Bon Bon is a girl. I knit her out of Art Yarn hand paint stripes in the color 127. And this yarn I purchased back in 2008. This is 9 years old. And I purchased it to make a pair of socks. And I got one shorty sock done. And it's been sitting in my stash ever since. I didn't take a single note on the kind of heel flap I did or how many stitches I cast on. I did realize I did this on a size 2 needle, but that's about it. I have no idea what else I did with this. So it's been hanging out for 9 years in my stash. So last night I was up way too late knitting this. I think I was up past 2 a.m. working on this guy. But I decided that I needed to make Bon Bon. And the reason I decided to knit Bon Bon is because, whew, I may not be able to hold it together, guys. So I started knitting back in 2007-ish, and the lady who taught me how to knit owned the yarn shop over in Aberdeen, that's where I grew up, and I knew her from church, and she's had kids my age, and so she was the one who taught me how to knit. She was my knitting mama. Well, a number of years ago, and I can't remember the number exactly, she had a battle with breast cancer. Survived it, but due to side effects from treatment, wasn't able to knit anymore. So she hasn't been able to knit for, gosh, I want to say 4 or 5 years. Maybe, I don't know. And she came out and told the Facebook community that cancer is back. I'm not going to go into quite the type of cancer because I'm not entirely 100% sure, but cancer is back in her body. And her doctors are making a plan right now, and she is one of the strongest women I've ever met. Anyway, so years ago, when she was knitting, she knit this little tiny frog stuffy that she named Ribbit. And Ribbit went with her everywhere, and friends of hers would steal Ribbit and take Ribbit on adventures. And last night, she posted a picture from when a friend of hers stole Ribbit and took Ribbit to a Mariners game. And she was saying how, oh, it was so fun, Ribbit, this, that, and other thing. Ribbit is somewhere lost in one of my knitting bags that she hasn't been able to touch in so long. So, in comes Bon Bon. So, I wanted to knit Bon Bon, not as a replacement for Ribbit, but a friend for Ribbit once Ribbit is out of hibernation in one of those knitting bags, but also something to just be cheery and to keep her company while she is going through this process all over again. So, I mean, she taught me to knit. She's my knitting mama, so she needed a little hand-knit toy and goodie from me. So I'm gonna get Bon Bon off in the mail this week to her. And just hope that she brings her a little bit of joy in a not so joyful time. So, I have to pull myself back together now. That's not fun to talk about. Nobody likes cancer. Nobody, I feel like everybody has been touched in one way or another, by that horrendous disease. And, yeah, so that's, I want Bon Bon to be a little bit of sunshine. So she's going to go off in the mail, and, a little love from the knitting community to someone who can't knit anymore. So, okay, pulling it together. Whew. I will be back momentarily. Okay, we're good. Let's move on to whips. Where am I at here? Sorry about that, guys. I'm an emotional person. I can cry like that over anything, big, small, whatnot, so. If I made you cry, I apologize. It's not my goal. I thought I'd be able to hold it together. Anyway, first whip I want to talk about is my Little Miss Chelsea Bean shawl. And this guy has kind of gotten put to the wayside. I have made progress on him. I was, oh, that's gonna be obnoxious. Metal needles clanking on my metal cold cup. So I was here, and so I've gotten, you know, a bit done. Again, this is a pattern that I was test knitting for the amazing Jen Sheelan. This pattern is now live on Ravelry. Okay, Jenny from Lucky Jenny Knits, kudos to you for getting this done prior to or right when the pattern went live, because I failed. And Jen, I feel like it's partly your fault because you have the Guilty Pleasures Cal going on right now. This is what I should have been working on, and I made Bon Bon. I have another thing here that I'll talk about in a little bit that just took up my time. So I totally set this aside, but I'll pick it back up this week and get some more sections done on it, in hopes that it will be done by the next podcast, because it is a really gorgeous shawl. I am knitting this out of Happy Feet by Plymouth in the 100 Splash. It's kind of their speckly. It's, you know, for being a non-indie dyed yarn, I love the speckles in this. I think they are so fun. And this is color 104, so it's mostly brown speckles with little flecks of navy and orange and yellow. Every once in a while, there's a crazy little pink guy that'll pop up in there, but it's a really fun speckle. As far as the pattern goes, I love the lace. The lace is my favorite, and the same reason that Jenny from Lucky Jenny Knits said, on the purl side, you get to drop stitches, which is always fun. So I have the Plymouth Happy Feet in color 104, and then the Luette Gems in the marine blue. And I have two skeins of that. Here's my little tiny ball that I'm still working from on this one. And the amazing Jen Sheelan. God, I love this woman. A, she has been coming up with some amazing stuff in her dye pots, so stay tuned for that, because I want them all. All of them. But she offered the pattern to give away to you guys. So I'm gonna put up a giveaway thread in the Ravelry group, so jump on over there. And oh goodness, what do I want the prompt to be? Of course I didn't think about this. Let's do dream yarns that you would knit the Chelsea Bean shawl out of. Oh no! Okay, so Chelsea Bean is her bulldog that she adopted. I want to know about your animal. Tell me about your fur baby. And if you have multiple, tell me about all of your fur babies, because I, at the moment, am fur babyless. However, in college, I had, with my roommate, adopted a Australian Shepherd who was like the coolest dog in the entire world. His name was, registered name was RF Red Solo Cup. I'm clicking my pen. And we called him Toby Keith. And he was, is, he's still alive, insanely smart and just the coolest dog I had ever lived with and helped raise and train. So that is my fur baby, Toby. And I'll try to put in a picture of him so you can kind of see what he looked like when I put in that giveaway thread. So yeah, in that giveaway thread, I want you to tell me about your fur baby. And then next podcast, I will draw a winner for the Little Miss Chelsea Bean shawl. Perfect. Haha. I should write that down. Tell about your fur baby. Okay. Next up in the whip department is socks. And this, along with my art yarn, was yarn that I picked up on that same, it was like a yarn crawl I did with some people in Portland. I don't remember which store I got this. This one was from the Pearl District. Yeah, Pearl District Yarns. I don't remember what this one was from, but this is my opal sock. And you may be thinking, Lacey, that's a really long sock. It's because I'm doing an afterthought everything. So I am using my US 1 2.25. Yeah, 2.25 millimeter 9-inch circs from Chowgu. And I am just knitting one long giant tube, and I'm gonna cut them apart, and I'm gonna put in an afterthought toe, afterthought heels, and they're gonna be awesome. I'm really excited about it. I used the cast on, is a different cast on, and look at how stretchy that is. Wah, wah, wah. This is the Jenny's Stretchy Slipknot Cast On, and I first heard about this from Candy from the Pause for Stitches podcast, because she was really obsessed with a little potato chippy edge. How cool is that? At first I hated this cast on. I found it to be really finicky. I missed my Twisted German cast on, but I wanted to give it a go because Candy raved about it, and now I'm really happy with it. So I've figured out how to do it and the feel of it and the rhythm of it. I don't know if I'll continue to use it on all of my socks. I do like my Twisted German cast on, but it will be part of the rotation for cast ons, I think. I'm going to do the Kirby Warby cut in afterthought heel again. I probably, I need to finish my Mercury socks to see how much of my silver sparkly gray yarn from Knit Picks I have left. And that might be the toes. And then I'll just do a stripey kind of bullseye heel with the opal, but it's just a sock. It's just an afterthought sock. Really fun, bright colors. I did get a knot in here that I took care of. I hate it when you get knots in self-striping yarns. It's the worst. And this is in my little homemade Hue Loco tutorial bag. I want to do another one of them and make another bag. I want to sew again. Oh, my Chelsea Bean is living in a Molly Klein Design cupcake bag that she gifted to me in a swap. I love it. And yeah, we'll reset the camera before I get on to the next whip. The next whip that I want to talk about is another Stephen West pattern. It is at the moment living in another Molly Klein bag. This is my little Nomi bag. And When you finish one Stephen West pattern, you have to cast on another one. Like, there just should always be a Stephen West on the needles. And I'm not the only one who thinks this. So after I bound off my expiration station, I decided that it was time to finally, I purchased this yarn this last summer. It was finally time to cast on my Daybreak shawl. And this is really wrinkly because it's been stuffed in its little bag. Arg. Okay. So, there we go. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen this a few times, especially because a few weeks ago, the last time I worked on this, it matched my Sweet Legs leggings. The teal yarn is Cascade Heritage Sock Yarn, which is just a 75-25 yarn blend. Surprisingly soft though for being a 75-25. And a relatively inexpensive sock yarn as well. So if you need a good solid color for something, check out the Cascade Heritage because I'm a fan. I appreciate it. This was wound by hand using my boyfriend's feet to hold the yarn because he didn't want to give me his hands. So it's kind of a mess right now. Oh my gosh, it's a major mess right now. What happened? Ooh, I don't want to. Okay. Yeah. And it's just this really pretty teal color. The color that I'm using for the stripe section is Noro, and it is the Taiyo. Again, just like my German's really bad, my Japanese is really bad too. The Taiyo sock, and it is color S9. And it has all of these really beautiful tealy pinks, limes. It's getting into like some browns and teals, browns and tans right now. It's gonna throw some purple in there, some silver, like it's some really cool colors in here. And I have, marking my progress, a Rock Candy progress keeper from Be Easy by LB, who Lindsay, awesome for snagging yarn hoarder at that wool festival, because you're gonna get a ton of people now. So I'm excited for your little business because your Lindsay's progress keepers are so unique and so pretty and so gorgeous. And I'm such an itty bitty little new podcast that I'm hoping some of you guys have gone and checked out her shop, but I know with the amount of followers that Amber from the Yarn Hoarder has, your shop's gonna explode now. So congratulations. I'm really excited that you were able to get that shout out. Yeah, so go check her shop out before she sells out of everything because she's going to. And again, Be Easy by LB is her Etsy shop, and I'll put that all down here like I usually do. So this pattern has a garter edge. And in the pattern, Stephen says, you know, be careful, you know, do it really, those first two stitches really loose. So you have the stretch when it comes to blocking. Well, in the teal, I was able to get some decent stretch, you know, and be okay. And even on one side of my stripes is okay. But the side that I'm carrying my yarn is tight. So again, Stephanie, Mean Girls Podcast, help me brainstorm and help me remember about the whole, when you're doing those edges, do you would knit one, yarn over, knit one, turn your work, and then just drop the yarn over, and that just gives you extra stretch and extra yarn within the stretch, within the edge of that shawl. So I did the same thing in my, Waiting for Rain shawl that I knit this last summer. And so I'm a few stripes in, but it's not going to matter in the long run. So I'm going to start doing that extra kind of yarn over, for the rest of the shawl. So I have that stretch along that edge. Okay. Next up again, I guess I have 6 whips that I'm showing you today. So this is going to be a longer episode. I just have a lot to talk about and I'm trying to just continue on with them. So living in my Ebony Pearl, project bag, is my newest cast on, aside from Bon Bon, because that was cast on and finished, cast on yesterday, finished today. I have had this yarn sitting in my stash for like 2 years now. I started one top with it and didn't pay attention to the directions and knit it like 5 inches too much, and skipped some waist shaping, and it's just been languishing ever since. Like, I even ripped the needles out of it and used it for a different project, and I finally decided that I wanted to use this yarn. And so I'll show you the project first. So I am knitting, it's a new pattern on Ravelry, and it is called the Bradley Beach Tee by Joan Forgione? I am so bad at names, guys. But again, I'll have that all down here for you. I don't have any lost stitches. It's just this really cool t-shirt. Doesn't look like a whole lot. It's got some twisted rib that runs up the side and gets narrower. It comes to a point. Let's talk about this. So within this panel, you are doing center double decreases, and so it just gets smaller and smaller until it gets to a point. There we go. I am knitting the size large, but my gauge will give me something even, I think, a little bigger than the extra large, which means that it might be too big and I might run out of yarn. And I even had to buy a skein off of someone's stash on Ravelry. So I'm still plugging along. I am, let's see here, on my 6th of 9 skeins. So I still have I have another one in my living room, the one that I got in the mail. Full skeins, my little partial. And I'm almost to the bust point. So I'm hoping I'll have enough, because they are just little short sleeves. They're not, you know, I don't know. It's a little scoop neck, nothing fancy on the neck. So we'll see. I may have to beg and plead the person that I bought the one skein from to see if she'll be willing to sell me a second skein. Because if I'm that close to being done, I don't want to add in a new color just for like the sleeves or the edge on the sleeve. Like, that just seems silly to me. So this is my Bradley Beach Tee. It is being knit out of Barocco Fuji, which is a 38% silk, 25% cotton, 22 rayon, 15 nylon. So it has a decent amount of silk in it, so it's got some cool drape. It's got some cool kind of nubby texture to the yarn, which I appreciate. And it'll just be a good spring lightweight top. So maybe that'll be done by the next time I'm podcast. We shall see. But this is what my guilty pleasure knit was. I was insanely monogamous on that over spring break. I brought all of these other whips with me on break. That's the only one I knit on. There you go. I have 2 more whips to show you. Yes. And they're both crochet, and they're both blankets. The first one is a baby blanket, and this is for the same baby that I started the green plant knit blanket, the sprout blanket. Is that what it's called? Going back in my notes. Yeah, the sprout blanket. I'm over it. It's a fun blanket. I'm gonna leave it on the needles and I may get back to it for somebody else. But I've decided for that baby, I wanted a crochet blanket. And I blame Lynn from Sunshine and Bubblegum podcast, because she showed the tutorial for the chainless foundation in crochet, and she was doing it for this blanket, and I really liked it, so I had a copier. And so I'm also making the Annie baby blanket by Little Doolally, and that's what I got so far. I started that last night after I got home. I am knitting this out of just some acrylic yarn that I got on clearance at Michael's, I think, and it is just Isaac Mizrahi craft, and the gray, it's insanely soft. I think the overarching brand is Premier, and so just, it's a really nice soft acrylic. The gray is called Castle, and then the blue is called Charming. And for the little boy that will be the recipient of it, I think Castle, Charming, it'll work. We'll see how much gray I have at the end of all of this. I may not have enough to do the border in gray, which is fine. I have plenty of the blue to do the border in blue. I just hope I have enough gray to do the whole blanket, because it's a decent size blanket. I mean, it's probably 48 inches. I think it's at least 4 feet across. So yeah, so that's my Annie blanket. And I am using a H or a five, you're not gonna see that, why am I doing that? A 5mm hook, which is larger than the pattern calls for, so what are you getting? The next crochet blanket I wanna show off is living in this lovely little paper bag. And it is, my granny stripe blanket. And I haven't shown this off in a while. I've got so many ends going on here. I've woven in like two ends, I think. But this is, again, why am I saying again? But this is my granny stripe blanket. I have, since you've seen it last, where's my marker? Okay. I have done all of that. So from here, so that lime green, not lime green, but from the bright green to the top. And all of those are minis that I got from Amy, who is the Amy's Knotted, oh, goodness, we're going back again. Amy's Knotted Knits podcast. I'm so sorry about that. I knew it was Amy's Knotted something. But she, so these are all minis that I got from her. I have a few more left to add in, but then her little section will be done in my blanket. And I am loving this thing. It is a lot of fun. I love the variegated self-striping yarns in it, because it constantly, the color is constantly changing and shifting. I'm gonna talk about it. I don't like this white stripe. I'm not a fan. I think if I get like a really bright, solid color like that again, I'll only do across rather than across and back. Just so it's not so solid amidst everything else that's not solid. I mean, I have a few other, I have a brown speckled, and then I have this kind of berry color, and those are both solid or tonal, but I think the white was just too bright, but I'm not going back and I'm not changing it. So yeah. And so in here, this thing is chock full of minis that I still need to add to this blanket, and I keep collecting more from people, which is awesome. I love it, because I'm gonna need them for this. But I need to get going on this. I don't need to get going on anything, actually. If I don't want to work on it, I'm not gonna work on it. But it's, I'm definitely collecting more and more minis. I have, I'm yet to put in a single mini of my own from socks that I finished this year. I have minis now from my exploration station that I'm gonna wanna put in. I probably won't have anything left from the Chelsea bean, but all of my socks. So yeah, there are a lot of minis to go into that. And if you want to donate to the collection, let me know. Hit me up, because I'll take donations. Okay. That is it for whips. Done. Let's move on to some acquisitions. So it has been a good yarny 3 weeks. And it's gonna get good too, because I've got stuff that's coming from Knit Picks this week. That's why I have to get that Bradley Beach D off the needles, because I'm gonna be starting another cardigan here pretty soon. So let's talk about this. So for Valentine's Day, my boyfriend was hoeing and humming, what do you want? And I'm not a big flowers, chocolate, like I can't, like I'm just gonna complain about getting fat from the chocolates and the flowers are gonna die. So I told him, I was like, honestly, I want yarn. And you may think it's silly, but I want yarn. And so I sent him to Nomadic Yarns and told him, pick me out anything. I will be happy with absolutely anything from Nomadic. And you know, I was like, there's this, but he's a Harry Potter nerd like I am. I told him there's a bunch of Harry Potter colors. There's not a single one I don't like. So whatever one you want to get me, I'm totally going to be happy with. And I gave him the specification. I want it on a sparkle base. And I want it in a cake form, because then I can do it two at a time and use the button method to pull from the inside to the outside. And we'll see if I still do that. I don't know. But caked up, I like the gobstopper balls, adorable, cute, love them. I prefer to work from a cake, so yeah. So he didn't get me one, but two skeins of Nomadic, which, hello, how exciting is that? So the first one I knew he would pick because it's his favorite, one of his favorite characters, and that's the lovely Luna. And so this is the Luna colorway from Nomadic Yarns. It's got that awesome gold and peach and pink. And again, this is on her sparkle base. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see that. And the other one he picked surprised me. But it doesn't, because they're very much his colors. And he even hinted at, you know, making something for him. And I told him, yeah, if you want socks made out of this, don't get it on the sparkle base. Because he double checked the colors with me before he hit the purchase button. But the second color is Lupin. And he, you know, still got me the sparkle base, but I may have to order him a skein of Lupin and make him a pair of socks out of it, because they are his colors. They're navy and two different grays and brown, and it's really gorgeous. And it honestly is not a color I would have purchased myself, but that makes me really love it even more, because he picked it and I see him in these socks. So these are my Nomadics. I do want to get some contrasting colors for heels and toes and cuffs to work with these, but they're gonna have to wait till my next Knit Picks order, because I spent too much money on this one. So there's that. My next acquisition I feel really lucky to get, because this is something that this dyer only dyes up a couple times a year, which I love that she didn't announce that it was in her shop. She kind of did. She like hinted at it, but it just meant that people were actually able to kind of stumble upon it and get it. And so you can probably guess, but I am talking about Lolo Did It in her Pretty Young Thing colorway. And guys, this seriously is some of the coolest yarn I have ever, ever had my hands on. The dye, the colors, the speckling, I'm gonna try to undo it. I'm not a dyer, so reskeining this is gonna be a pain in the butt, but look at how cool this is. I mean, so many crazy colors in there. Look at that. Kind of, it reminds me of like toxicity. I don't know. This is such... Okay, so her speckles are awesome, but I love that there's not any speckles right there. I mean, seriously, look at how cool this is. Also, can we talk about this for a second? If you have watched the what is it now? It's Yarn Cafe, Girls at the Yarn Cafe, their podcast. Tristan and, oh goodness, why can't I think of her mom's name now? Ooh. Christy, I believe. Christy took part in the Grocery Girls spring swap. Her swap partner gave her a skein of Lolo Pretty Young Thing. Are you kidding me? The fact that this is so hard to come by, that it's so, it's, she only dyes it every so often, and she got it in a swap? Christy, I don't think you realize how lucky you are, because holy cow, this yarn is absolutely stunning. And yeah, I kind of did okay. But yeah, this, it's just an amazing skein of yarn. I have no idea what it's going to become. I kind of want it, I got it in her everyday sock. Yeah, which is a 75-25. Which gives me 463 yards to work with. So it may go into a shawl. I have no idea what shawl I want it to go into, but it's just gorgeous. It's just stunning. So yeah, Lolo did it, Pretty Young Thing. When she does it again, get your hands on it, because you need it in your life. Everybody should have a skein of this in their life, and I don't care how, oh, there you go, you know, not into neons and speckles and what, but it just, the dyeing of it is so cool. You just, you have to get it. You have to get it, and I'm really hoping one of these will be my shots for YouTube, because I just want to show off this yarn forever. It's that cool. But I got it. Yay! And that was also a gift from the boyfriend. My yarn budget had been spent, and I was down visiting him, and I saw it, and I kept showing him on the screen, look at how pretty this is, I need this in my life. And he just handed me his card. He's the best, he really is. So yeah. Okay, that's enough with my yarn going of that prettiness. My next acquisition is yarn, but it is already in a sweater. What? You're telling me, Lacey, what are you, what's going on? So I decided that I wanted to partake in Wool Jewel's Great Unravel Cal, who she's co-hosting with other people, and I just don't know who they are, so I'll have to check them out. But it's a whole, you get a sweater, you unravel it, you make something out of the repurposed yarn, and you enter the cal. And so I may go hunt, I found this at a Goodwill over at the coast when I was home visiting my family. And it does, it's not 100% natural fiber. It is a, I kind of already started to pick apart. where is that here? It's 66% acrylic, 27 polyester, 6% wool, 1% other, which I think is a sparkle in it. But I just love the color, and I envision this becoming a hat with a really fun and funky pom-pom on it. It might be a fur one, I may use the yarn for the hat, I don't know. But this, I've decided, is gonna be a hat. So, it's just, it's a cool sweater. If it were my size, I may keep it in sweater form, but it's a little small, so I'm not going to. So I'm gonna take it apart and turn it into a hat for the Wool Jewel Great Unravel Cow. My next two acquisitions are not yarny related, but they are, I see them pop up frequently on podcasts, so I wanted to share them with you, and especially because I purchased them, but my little brother picked them up for me. So my little brother is part of the University of Washington marching band. He's part of their drum line. He plays the big old bass drum. And for football season, they made it to, you know, almost, it was like the semifinals. I don't remember what they called it. But they traveled to Atlanta for the Peach Bowl, where they played, oh Lord, why can't I remember who they played? Bama. They played Bama. And so while he was there, I said, I need you to pick me up. I don't want a souvenir from the game. I don't want anything like that. I want you to pick me up an Atlanta Starbucks mug. So he got me an Atlanta mug. And by he got me, I paid for it. I just sent him a screenshot of my Starbucks app, which worked perfectly. So this is adding to my collection. And then, again, this kid gets to do all of these cool things with the band. Over St. Patrick's Day, they traveled all the way to Ireland to march in the St. Patrick's Day parade in Dublin. And again, I told him the only thing I want is a Starbucks mug from Ireland. That is all I want. Well, he said that he couldn't find a single Starbucks while they were in Ireland, not even in the airport, which really surprised me and really bummed me out because I wanted one. But when they flew back and were stateside in the airport, he had some time and he found a Starbucks. And they had mugs for various places, and I said, surprise me, I have the New York one already, but any of the other ones I don't have, so pick out whatever one you think is coolest and I'll take it. And so he got me Washington DC, which is really cool. It's a cool mug. I love how it has the cherry blossoms, and I like the gray inside. I don't think any of the ones I have so far have the gray inside. So yeah, so no Ireland mug, but I did get DC. So my collection has grown and I'm quite excited about it. And those are my two non-yarny acquisitions. But again, I see a lot of podcasters, including myself, I have used my mugs on this. And I do know that, who is it? Jilly from the Knitting Broomstick is hosting a You Are Here mug swap in her podcast group. So the Knitting Broomstick, go check it out. I cannot afford to take part in it this month, which is a bummer because again, I love these mugs and I love getting them from other places, even if I've never been there before. But maybe I'll host one myself when I can afford to do it myself. So, yeah, if you're interested, it might still be of it. You might still be able to sign up. I'm not entirely sure, but go check it out. Yeah. Ooh, I do have one more acquisition, and this was in my adventure to Joanne's this morning to get my eyes for little Miss Bon Bon over here. I needed to get the safety eyes because they're just way better than embroidering them on. But while I was in line at Starbucks at Joanne's, waiting to buy my eyes, I saw this bag. And I knew that I had to have it. I don't need another bag. I need another bag like I need a hole in my head. And then I realized, wait, I've seen other people come up with other bags. And where's that one? I want that one too, because it matches my mug. And I found it. And it's the procrastinating. And these are at Joanne's right now. I didn't see the mug that matches this particular bag, but if you want the bags, go to Joanne's, get them. They're really inexpensive. I think the little one was like $1.99. The little one was $1.99, and the big one, no. Okay, the small one was $1.59, and the big one was $1.99. So they're really inexpensive. They're just the reusable kind of grocery bag, but this will be great to put my projects in for knit night and carry, and it's knitting themed and I love it. So that wraps up my acquisitions and leads me into a few minutes of chit-chat. So, like I said, this last week was my spring break. I have to go back to work tomorrow. I don't think I ever said what day it was. It is Sunday, April 9th. Oh, sorry, my phone is being stupid. So, yeah, Monday I have to go back to work. And over break, the first weekend of break, I drove over to the west side to visit my family, celebrate some birthdays, and I had the opportunity to meet up with Stephanie from the Mean Girls podcast. And I'm really bummed that Rebecca couldn't make it. She hurt herself and gardening. Stop that. No. So she wasn't able to make it to meet up, so I didn't get to meet Rachel, but I did get to meet Stephanie, which was really awesome. We met at a Panera up in Lacey, and we closed down the Panera. I mean, it was a wild Sunday night for us. Oh my gosh. But she, let me tell you, is such a cool person. I feel like we have a lot of similarities as far as the men in our life and their professions and what they do and our perspective on things, and just, yeah, she was really fun to hang out with and get to know more. And I mean, we sat there for hours knitting, and she shares a little story on her podcast of a mean guy that we didn't appreciate his comments, and I'll let her share that story. So go check out her podcast if you want to hear about the mean guy that I wanted to make really not nice hand gestures at. And in fact, I may have behind his back. I don't know. But, oh, there's a story. So we sat there and we talked about anything and everything, and we shared the projects that we were working on, and we talk about other podcasts. We kind of tested the podcasting gods, and I'm really surprised they didn't like throw down some lightning bolts and, you know, shame us, because I mean, I'm an honorary mean girl now. So we had some mean girl moments, but it was just our honest opinions about things, and I'm not going to share them here because I don't have to. So but she was just really, you know, I can't form a sentence right now. I really enjoyed my time with her. I am really glad that her and her sister live on the same side of the mountains that my parents live on, because I'm gonna go see my parents again. That's going to happen. Which means that hopefully I can meet up with both of them at one point and we can continue to be mean girls together, because, yeah. But it was a lot of fun. I would highly recommend you go check out her and her sister's podcast, the Mean Girls podcast, because Stephanie has turned into an amazing sock knitter, and she is starting to crank out her socks. Rebecca finished a freaking sweater in a week. Girl, I have no idea how you did that, because I have a much larger body to knit for. That's going to be my excuse, because I worked monogamously on my Bradley Beach Tee all week, and I'm not even at the armpit yet, so I don't know. So they're just awesome, down-to-earth girls. Tell it like it is. I mean, the name of their podcast says it all. I mean, they're not mean. They're not horrible human beings. They just tell things how they see it, and it's a no BS kind of podcast, which I really love. I love the realness behind them. So go check them out. Hey Stephanie. Hey Rebecca. Yeah, that's I think it'd be a wrap up for this week. Yeah, I feel like I've chatted your ear off for a long time now, and I'm gonna go edit now and do some knitting and grocery shopping, because I've gotta get back into that groove of making lunches for next week. So yeah, I hope you guys have a fantastic week. It'll probably be 2 weeks again before my next podcast. I likely will not be podcasting next weekend, but the weekend after I will. So have a great couple weeks and happy knitting. I'll talk to you later. Bye.